Shalom again. Welcome back to the Light to the Nations. In this short video, I want to share with you a method to identify the true north using the sun and a sundial. It is very important to identify the true north. As you know, there are two north north that you can identify. One is the magnetic north, that is basically any compass is using. And the other one is the true north. There is a big difference between the two of them. And actually, if we are monitoring and using a sundial, we need to use the true north, not the magnetic north. So why is this so important? Because by identifying the true north, we can identify the true due east and the due west. So this is a very important information when you are setting up a sundial, any of the two sundials that I showed in the last video, especially for the second one, okay? That you need to point it out directly to the true north. So let me show you in the sundial what's the method you need to use. So basically, you use the gnomon. The gnomon is this piece, in this case of a nail that I'm using. And you need to start using, start measuring basically the shadow of the gnomon over the sundial. But first you need to do it in a period of time. First you need to identify the solar noon. Solar noon is basically when we have the sun over our heads, when we're pointing to the north. So how to identify this approximately? Basically, in most of the location, the solar noon, depending on the season of the year, is happening between 1 o'clock in the afternoon to 2 o'clock. Okay. As a reference, and to do this exercise, you can go to timesanddate.com and look for your location. Go to sun calculator, and you can see in the table what is the solar noon. In this case, for example, I did this exercise yesterday, and the solar noon here in Santiago, in the place I live, it was the 10 to 2 o'clock in the afternoon, so 1:50. So what's the idea to do this exercise? As soon as you have an approximate hour of the solar noon, you need to start measuring 1.5 hour before until 1.5 hour later. So for example, I'm going to show you here. So solar noon, and I identify was at 1:50, as I said. So I started to measure at 12:20 in the afternoon. So what's the mark that I did is this one over here. So basically the shadow was pointing in this direction and was ending here. So what we need to do is basically, as soon as we mark this point at the 1.5 hour before the solar noon, we put a ruler just to calculate the length. So in this case, and I'm using centimeters, so the length was 7.8 centimeters. So what's the idea? As soon as we identify the length, we need to start monitoring close to the 1.5 hour later or after the solar noon, meaning is around 3:20 in this case, 1.5 hour after the 1:50 is 3:20 in the afternoon yesterday. Start monitoring the length of the shadow of the gnomon over the sundial. And as soon as you have the same length, you need to put a mark. So in this case, I'm showing to you, sorry for that, is over there, the same 7.8. Okay? So basically, it's identified, the first mark is identifying the length. And then later, after solar noon, you need to identify the same length and put a mark over there. As soon as you have the two marks, you need to, as you can see here, you need to put a straight line, or you need to join the two marks, the two points together, so you have the a straight line. And as soon as you have that, you can use the some colors. You need to identify the perpendicular line between the gnomon and the line that you already draw here. So it's basically, because of the shadow, maybe you cannot see it clearly, but there is a line that I marked over here. And actually I continue that line later with the same ruler over here. So basically this line is marking to me the true north. So the direction of the true north is in that direction. So what I did, for example, with this sundial, I will try to show you with the camera. Just give me a second. I just put this tool over here on the line. Okay, let me show you. It's over there. And basically, you can point it out directly. It's very difficult to see, but let me try to do it. You can see there are two ends, and later is a line with the gnomon at the end, and this ruler over there. So basically, by doing that, I have identified that the true north is in that direction, and this one is exactly pointing out to the true north. So this is a very basic exercise, but an important one, in order to identify the true north. And this is very important, especially if you are using sundials, because as I said, identifying the true north, we are able to identify that the due east is in that direction and the due west is directly in a straight line to this direction. Okay? So, hope this information is useful for you. In case you are new with sundials, important to identify the true north. And even if you are in any place and you don't have any compass and you are lost and you need to identify the true north, this is a way to do it. So that's it from the moment. YaHuWaH be with you all, and see you in the next video. Bye.